Welcome to 2020 Taiwan-US-Japan Trilateral Indo-Pacific Security Dialogue.
COVID-19 pandemic allowed us to witness the fragility of life and to understand the importance of mutual assistance. There is a possibility that we might face yet another outbreak, but regardless of how daunting the future challenges are, the international community can always count on us.
I also believe that there is so much that the United States and Taiwan can do together. I'm proud of the fact that for 30 years, I feel like I've been a strong friend of Taiwan, as Randy and others in the audience have as well. I also just want to underscore that we're not alone any longer, that this is a broad group of people that understand the strategic significance of the relationship, and I just want to give you my commitment to do what I can in the period ahead.
The topic of the session one is the impact of U.S. presidential election results on the situation of Indo-Pacific and the Taiwan Strait.
Japan-U.S.-Taiwan trilateral cooperation also made progress, particularly in the form of GCTF.
We need to think more boldly in India about the importance of India-Taiwan relationship.
Australia would not be involved with the United States in the defense of Taiwan against a Chinese attack. It would fundamentally unravel our alliance with the United States, and we would not allow that to happen.
I have rather a long title for this session, Building Trusted Industrial Supply Chain in the Indo-Pacific in Light of COVID-19 and Regional Dynamics.
The U.S., Japan, and Taiwan agree to make available to one another with some degree of security of supply.
Japan and Taiwan can be a very natural partner to share common interests.
That, you know, Taiwan and the United States or even Japan can cooperate on that digital transformation and maybe some talent recruiting methods.
Keeping with the tradition of the Taiwan-US-Japan trilateral dialogue, we always have a congressional discussions session.
Taiwan Straits peaceful, stable station, current status quo, is also the national interest of Japan, and I think it is also the national interest of the United States.
Working with my colleagues in Taiwan and Japan as we help rebuild the region, the global economy, and continue to fight for, you know, the rule of law, maritime security, and freedom of navigation.
Taiwan stands at the forefront of the geostrategic, geopolitical, and geoeconomic competition between China and the rest of the world. Obviously, for policymakers in Washington, Tokyo, or even New Delhi, Taiwan should be seen as a strategic asset, not a strategic burden or even liability.
And to put Taiwan in the right position, that we are not just under a category of China's Taiwan problem, but we will be one of the key countries to work together to solve this difficulty right now we are facing.
Mr. Blinken cherished the stability in the Taiwan Strait and encouraged the dialogue between Taiwan and Beijing. I will not be surprised, therefore, if he continues to do so when he returns to the State Department.
So I just conclude here that this is a very timely event while we are waiting for the new U.S. administration in the face of the very fluid and uncertain COVID-19 period.
So stabilizing values and force of other democracy, evolving and established democracies, they will be also playing a key role. It is in this context I welcome and appreciate the good discussion taking place today.
I think we've also discovered that the importance of Taiwan and Taiwan's continued survival and existence and ability to sustain its freedom and democracy so that it can be a contributor to preserving the freedom and qualities of the Indo-Pacific.
The power of the American economy and Japanese and Taiwanese economies working together, along with those of other regional partners, provides formidable negotiating leverage vis-a-vis China. And our Indo-Pacific strategy must be grounded in our like-minded partners, starting with Tokyo and Taipei.